Today I'm going to teach you how I make these beer mugs with an antler for a handle. They're good for beer or for coffee, cold drinks, hot drinks, and you can make any shape that you want. Let's go. I'm going to make a beer mug using this pecan or pecan piece of wood. So I don't need to be very exact. Just well centered. Now we're gonna rough it. Maybe a little faster. It's time to vibrate there.
Always wear your eye protection. I like the full face mask.
Beautiful. Okay. Okay, what's left now is to sand it. We're gonna sand it, start at 120, going all the way to 600. After sanding it, we're gonna finish it with a sanding sealer. And after the sanding sealer, we're gonna put some polish, friction polish, and it'll be ready to get the antler on. Okay, it's been sanded and finished. Look at those colors. Now we're gonna put the antler on. Where's my antler? It's right here. It's gonna go like this for a handle. So I'm gonna cut it off a little bit here, and I'm gonna make sure I cut all these hairs from the deer. And then we're gonna glue it. Okay, it's shaped. So I'm marking where the antler is gonna sit, and I'm gonna ground off a little bit here and a little bit here. Okay, I have my Dremel with a thin sanding disc. See how this sits now. I have a lot more surface here. A lot more surface here. You see that? Now I'll put a little bit of super glue here and here. Now this is what's gonna hold it in place. I'm gonna put wood glue a little bit in all the crevices, in all the areas where it connects, where the wood touches the antler. And I'm gonna fill it with some of this sawdust from the same turning, the thin sawdust that I have here around my lathe. That gives it a lot of surface of contact. And now I add super glue to those wood chips, to the sawdust.
There you go. I'm gonna put some more super glue to make sure it stays there forever. As long as I don't yank on it, it will stay put. I've tested it thoroughly. And we're ready to line the inside. There you go. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do next. I'm gonna line all these three mugs with resin, with epoxy resin. So this is a two-part resin. By volume, you combine them. So for every cup of these, you use a cup of these. For these three mugs, I'm gonna mix 100 milliliters. Maybe a little much, but I'd rather have a little much than not enough. Now it's time to stir and stir and stir until the whiteness is gone. You see that milky? I have to stir until it becomes clear. I'm gonna be stirring for a while. Okay, I've been mixing for about 4 minutes and it's completely clear. It has some bubbles, but the mix is completely clear. So now I have 30 minutes of work time, but I won't be needed so much. So I'm gonna start putting it into the mugs. So I'm gonna put about a third into each. I'm getting close to getting it all covered. I need to make sure the inside is covered as well. And then I'm gonna drain the excess into a cup, a little plastic cup or something. I may make a little blank for a wine stopper or a Christmas ornament. Okay, I'm back with the first one. Give it another round. And I've seen them where you put them in a slow lathe, like 10 revs per minute. And it's just turning like that, turning. The problem is the bottom. I want to have a fat layer at the bottom, a thick layer at the bottom. And that technique doesn't allow to have a good layer at the bottom. So I'd rather do this, have some coverage on the walls. And then let it sit, let it stand upside up for the rest of the night. That'll give me that nice layer at the bottom. You see all that is accumulated there? That's gonna sit at the bottom, let me See if I can show you that. So you see now it's creating a nice thick layer. If it's too much, we can empty some. Okay, this is the one that has too much. So I'm gonna take some of it off. And I'm going to use some of this resin to add to the joints. Okay, so let me show you the inside. Drain some. Okay, it's ready. It dried overnight and now it's ready to drink out of it. Now it's all up to your imagination. You can make them tall, you can make them short, use wooden handles, no handles. They're great for Game of Thrones fans. You'll feel like a Viking. Every hunter should have one. There you go.